Today I'm breaking down the 5 biggest updates that could transform how to build your games and what they mean for your workflow. Also, we just hit another major milestone on this channel, and I'm giving away a $50 Steam or Amazon gift card to celebrate. Stick around to the end to find out how to enter. Let's get into it, starting with the most requested feature of all, Foliage. Nanite Foliage is finally here in UE 5.7. That means trees, grass, and bushes now fully support Nanite. No more ugly LOD popping, real-time dynamic lighting with Lumen. And best of all, best performance. Epic demoed a scene with over 70,000 trees running at nearly double the FPS. If you're building open-world survival games or anything with dense landscapes, this is a massive upgrade. But great foliage is only part of the picture. To handle massive open spaces, you also need smarter streaming. Enter the next big feature, World Partition, plus fast geometry streaming enhancements. What's new? Smoother loading, unloading of actors, reduced memory spikes, more control over what loads and when. This upgrade is especially important for large multiplayer maps or seamless exploration zones. Now, let's talk about what ties all your world building together. If you make cutscenes or cinematic sequences, this is for you. New that is easier to navigate, nested timelines for complex edits, real-time previews with less crashing, it's a major quality of life improvement that makes storytelling and game presentation faster and cleaner. Now, MetaHuman is also leveling up in 5.7. New features include live facial animation captures from a webcam or a mic, custom body morphs and outfit tools, export support to Unity, Blender, and more. For indie devs, that means near AAA quality characters without a team or a big budget. Several powerful tools that were experimental in 5.6 are to go fully stable in 5.7, which is fast geometry streaming, motion matching for smooth animation transitions, Niagara fluids and volumetrics, control rig sculpting tools. These upgrades make it easier to build ambitious systems without fighting the engine. And just a heads up, everything I talked about here is based on current research, official Epic announcements, and early dev previews. Some features may change by the time 5.7 fully releases. Let's take a minute for the community spotlight. We're celebrating another 500 subscriber milestone. And if you've been around for a while, you might remember I gave away $25 when we first hit our 500 milestone. And now we're closing in on 1,600 subs, which is crazy. So I'm doing another giveaway, this time for a $50 Steam or Amazon gift card. Here's how to enter. Be subscribed to the channel and comment below with the UE 5.7 feature you're most excited for. That's it. I'll pick a winner from the comments and announce it in an upcoming video. Now, shout out time. Huge love to creator at Cemetery Gate, the creator of Cursed Dark 64, a retro Nintendo 64 inspired game being built in Unreal Engine 5. His devlogs are a great mix of nostalgic vibes and real indie dev struggle. And he just hit 500 subs himself. That's a major milestone when you're doing everything solo, and I totally respect that grind. So check him out. And if you're working on a game, share it in the comments. I might feature your project in a future video too. So yeah, Unreal Engine 5.7 is shaping up to be a monster update. To enter the $50 giveaway, make sure you're subscribed and leave a comment telling me which feature you're most hyped for. I'll announce the winner soon, and I can't wait to hear what you're working on. If you found this helpful, hit that like button, subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next one. And before you go, Unreal Engine 5.6 was already heaven sent when it comes to performance, especially for open world games. Check out the performance boost I got by upgrading my 5.5 project to 5.6. Just click the video on the right. Peace out, dev heads.